Welcome to tonight's game. It promises to be a good one between the Kansas Jayhawks and the Oklahoma State Cowboys. And here we have our two players who are the focus of our Star Watch for today's game. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
Keep your eyes on these two small forwards, Brad. They're both very talented, and you can expect to see them go at each other all game long.
All right, buckle up, folks. Here we go.
Let me tip off here in the first.
The Cowboys will be man up to begin the game, Dick. On the outside. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Turn around a fadeaway. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, the four-round one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunity.
He blocks the shot. Number 22 is called for the foul. First personal foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
That's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
As we take a look at the sophomore.
Brad, he's got that first year of experience under his belt. So this season, his team is going to be looking for him a lot more.
Nash makes his debut into the game.
I tell you, this kid comes in with fire, Brad. He really knows how to bring it.
Second one is good. Working it around the perimeter. They run it up into transition. For two, he can't get the hoop to fall.
That spacing.
He looks for three.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Scorches the net. Smart receives the ball. Takes his jumper off the mark. Moving it around the perimeter. Change of possession.
Trying to go inside.
With the jumper. Scorches the net with a J. Here's a double team. He attempts to dribble around the trap. Unsuccessful, though.
Hey, trap's giving that kid some fits.
Well, you know, basketball was like nutrition, Dick. His game would be broken down into the two major food groups, and that's passing and scoring.
When you combine those two skills, the floor looks a lot wider for everyone on your team.
Gave it up. He bombs from outside. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Call this a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He puts up the J and come up short. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. The point guard gets the pass. He goes up with it. Missed the jumper. looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. No.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For the bucket. He gets the bucket to fall. A great backdoor pass right there, Dick.
I'll tell you, what a great play. That's coaching. That's teaching. That's terrific execution. The backdoor cut from the weak side.
On the left side. Puts up the jumper. Scores it.
Up it inside.
The Jayhawks looking to attack now in transition. He shoots. Nails a sweet jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. From downtown. Nails the jumper. Working around the arc. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Jumper won't go. Puts it up. Nope. Secures the board.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Takes it strong to the hoop.
Well, when he gets positioning in the paint, it's usually game over for the opposition.
In the lane. Can't connect. The Jayhawks prefer a more balanced attack. They play up-tempo at times and then really settling in the half court at other times.
Brad, they like the balanced attack. They don't feel like they can always play up-tempo or always play in the half court. Therefore, they mix it up and do a little bit of both. I think this style works for them.
Brown handles the feed. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jump. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
He strokes it, knocked it down. Inside.
And the fans love it, man. They love it. Our house, baby, our house.
They work the perimeter. Around 8 minutes remaining. Jumper! He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. And the ball's out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. Got him trapped here, Dick.
Look at that trap, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He shoots from the corner. The missed shot. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Takes the pass in the paint, and he can't hit the shot. Looking for a good shot. Jumper off the mark. Gave it up. Now the turnaround jumper. Off the mark. Around the perimeter. Goes up with it. Gets the J to fall. The young man cut back door and the pass was right on time.
Great delivery on that back cut. He just hit him at the right time.
Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how the dribbler uses the screen is important in a pick and roll situation.
Two gets it to fall. They look to get it to the inside. Goes up for two. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Goes up with a shot. They get it to go. On the dribble, gives it up. We're at the 5-minute mark. Missed the jumper. We take a look here at each team's tempo, Dick.
Hey, the key to this game is not just who will set the tempo, but who can control it throughout the game.
There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Wow, partner, this crowd is something else when it gets going.
These fans love it, baby. They're more than a six man. This crowd is like a whole other team in the stands. This is what college basketball is all about.
He tries the jumper. Nails the jumper. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Brown receives the pass. Nails the J. For the bucket. He drains the bucket. 4 minutes left on the game clock. It in. He takes the shot. Can't get the shot to drop. Pushes it up. Jumper. Missed it. They work it around the perimeter.
There it is, Jam City.
About 3 minutes remaining. Now they work it around the perimeter. He attempts the three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
The student body is rocking tonight.
They're rocking right now. My goodness.
And let's take a look at a player who's really having a good game here tonight.
Might just do this thing. I tell you, Brad, just a great, great performance. I love this kid. He's a PTP-er, baby.
Gave it up. Goes up, knocks it down. Tries for two. It sticks. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Smart receives the ball. Refs call the foul the other way.
That's how you take a charge, baby.
Here's a look at each team's record, both their conference and their overall marks.
You always want to do well in conference games. I guarantee that getting the conference title is a goal for every team in America.
And a momentary look from three-point land. About a minute remaining, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
On the left side. He shoots from outside. Busts the jumper. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Takes his jumper. Shot clock is dead. On the outside. Takes the jumper and come up short. Brown handles the feed. Now the turnaround jumper. Off the mark for two. That's good. With the big shot. He misses it. At the half, the Cowboys are ahead by five. Oklahoma State did a masterful job of grabbing the boards in the first half, Mr. Vitale.
Wow, I'll tell you, Brad, these guys are so well coached. The coaching staff preaches the importance of winning the rebound battle. And then they went out there and they just did that.
Court man-to-man press, Mr. Vitale. Working it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Off the mark. He pulls up with a jumper. They got it. Pack it inside. He attempts the jump shot.
Excellent jump shot right there.
He throws it up from downtown. Jumper won't go. With a bucket. Off the glass and no good. Point guard receives the pass. He puts up the J. Off the mark. Wiggins receives the pass. Now trying to feed the low block. Tries for two. Can't connect.
Spacing.
Black getting after it and saves it. That goes out of bounds, and we'll stay at this end. The Cowboys have been getting it done tonight in a lot of different ways.
I tell you, it's been great to watch these kids really work with one another out there. They all have individual skills to put the ball in the hoop, but that isn't always what's best for a team. Everyone needs to get touches so they can feel involved.
Seconds on the shot clock. Drains the shot.
Watch your head, young fella.
Wiggins receives the pass. They get it to go. They've got to figure out a way to slow him down.
I'd start to get physical with him and I'd see what happens.
It looks as though the students are all wound up and ready to agitate the opposition.
You can't forget about them. The witty humor and dedication to their teams. You can't find this in any other team sport.
Moving it around the perimeter. Now looking to attack. For two. He gets the shot to fall. Green handles the feed from the corner.
Jumping in looked pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. The missed shot. The point guard takes the pass. Cowboys have a three-point shooter spotting up. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Puts up the shot. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the deep corner. Nope. Picked off. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Off the glass and no good. Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it. Here comes the ball screen. For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. He buries it. A great drive to the hoop right there, Dick.
Well, those aggressive moves to the basket are what this offense is all about.
Williams handles the feed from right at the circle. Dick, they're really running their offense through the high post right now.
They got the ball into the high post, and the defense couldn't react on time, Brad. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He tries the three ball. Off the glass and no good. Now looking for the ball screen, Dick.
Hey, a two-man game, Brad. So many teams incorporated into their scheme because it works.
Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Wiggins receives the ball. Ball down low. Puts it on the floor. Turn around and fade away.
Inside.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Missed it.
Take some pride on the defensive end.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper off the mark. They go into the low block. He shoots from the corner. Perfectly executed. Takes the fadeaway. Wow, the horrific shooting continues.
They can't buy one, Brad. This is embarrassing.
And we're at the 8-minute mark.
I think right now I've got to focus defensively.
Look at these fans. They're loving it.
Listen to that roar. It's unbelievable.
With a tremendous block. Oh, yes. Court. He shoots from the deep corner, scores it. Williams receives the ball, trying to feed inside. Stop and pop. He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
Out on the right wing. Gave it up. And now the fadeaway jumper. Missed the jumper. We're at the 7-minute mark. Puts up the trade. And come up short. Wiggins receives the pass. They'll work it around the arc. He goes for three. They got it. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior. Cowboys are on the run. Goes up for two. We're at the 6-minute mark. He hits it. Defense has really stepped up.
They're taking over the tempo very nicely.
They work the perimeter with the jumper. Scorches the net with a J. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Trying to feed the low block. Jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Turnaround fadeaway, knocks it down. Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounding. I wonder what it'll come down to in this game.
Takes the pass in the paint. About 4 minutes remaining. Feed the low post. Takes the jumper. He takes it. Gets the rejection. Wiggins handles the pass.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Down inside. Green saves it. And we're going the other way. Easy looks are getting tough to come by out there right now, Dick.
They're getting their hands on the number of shot attempts. The offense is struggling with the positioning and defensive timing, resulting in a bunch of blocked shots. They've been fun to watch at the defensive end.
Looking for a good shot. For two, the shot won't fall. They're working around the perimeter. 3 minutes left on the game clock. Inside, he shoots the jumper. He gets that one to fall. College basketball is special to me for that reason right there, Dick.
Oh, I couldn't agree with you more, Mr. Nestler. We are so lucky that we get to go to all these schools and experience the mayhem firsthand.
Now they'll bring it up. And a strip, quick hand. The Cowboys pushing the ball in transition. Throws it up. Out of bounds and a change of possession. Spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing them to make that turn.
They work it around the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He comes up empty. About 2 minutes remaining. Now they work it around the perimeter. He tries the jumper, bust the J. Right now, his team in front by two. And a momentary look from three-point land. Rejected. Wiggins. His inferior play is really affecting his composure now.
He's got to step out of it. His team needs him.
Puts up the tray. He misses the fadeaway. About a minute remaining. Fed the low block for the deuce. He gets it to fall. On the outside, he tries the three ball. He buries the jumper. Way out on top, controlling the ball. Goes up with a shot. Nope. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Shot clock is dead. Dick, what they need now is a quick score, right?
Then use as little time as possible.
Coach calls a timeout. We'll be back with more in a moment. Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Well, I think at this juncture, it's important that the players on the court are all communicating. This is a message that the coaches will likely convey to their players. Everyone realizes that the margin for error is small and that paying attention to the details is the most important at this point. Let's see what happens.
Well, Dick, it's always important to come out of a timeout with a game plan, I think.
You know, very important. It's a chance to get your team on the same page, talk about what's happened previously and what's about to happen in the future. I hate it when teams come out of a timeout unorganized and without a plan.
And we're back. Dick Vitale and Brad Nessler with you here, ready for the inbound after that timeout. On the outside. Puts up the jumper. He misses the jumper. Blocked. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? And the clock stopped with a foul. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And here's a look at the first-year player.
You know, playing at this level can be a tough adjustment for some kids. Others make the jump look easy. It all depends on what kind of team you have around you and how hard you are willing to work to get better.
It's good. With the long bomb. And he misses the shot. Oklahoma State played well against a good team tonight for the win.
But two teams like this, you knew the game was going to be close.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.